This video was realized for the 2022 Interdisciplinary Junior Congress at the Paris-Saclay University and covers methods and techniques implemented in the Dirty Card Library, on which I worked during my master's degree apprenticeship at the National Institute for Research in Computer Science and Automation. Let us say that we conducted a survey on salaries. We'd ask participants for some information on their current jobs, such as their job title, when they were hired, and how much they earn a year. Now, given some information about a new hired, we'd like to estimate their base salary depending on the market, that is, people that took our survey. For that, we could use a machine learning model, and salary prediction is actually a typical example of supervised learning. In this type of setting, we have a set of input features and a target we would like to predict. However, an important parameter to consider is that machine learning models are, in essence, mathematical models, and as such, they only work with numerical values. We must therefore transform our textual features into numerical features. For categorical variables, such as the job titles, we could use a one-hot encoding, which transforms each unique value into its own independent component of n-1 zeros and a single one mapping to the category. The keyword here is independent. This means that similarities in the feature, like for example between Police Officer 3 and Police Officer 1, are not accounted for. The issue is that, in reality, these similarities often have meaning. In this case, if we see the number as a rank, then the Police Officer 1 is likely to earn less than the Police Officer 3. We'd like the machine learning model to understand this relation. We can also note that a similar issue arises when the feature is not curated. In this case, we could see typos and variations in the data. OneHot would nonetheless encode these dirty occurrences independently, which is a problem. So, how can we account for these similarities directly in the encoders we use? Today, I'd like to talk about automatic methods for solving this type of issue that were introduced in the papers by Patricio Cerda et al. And implemented in the Dirty Cat library. They aim at simplifying the data cleaning steps in order to pass the dirty non-curated data directly to machine learning pipelines. Similarity encoding gives a similar result to OneHot, except that instead of using binary values, ones and zeros, we actually encode the similarity given a metric between each pair of sample. It works by taking two samples, which it will then decompose into meaningful representations, usually a character-level n-gram. We can construct this representation by dissecting the string into groups of n adjacent characters. For this example, we'll use groups of 3 characters, therefore 3 grams. Next, we'll simply do a ratio of how many 3 grams both have in common. We repeat the operation for each pair of sample, which results in a similarity matrix. With the Gamma-Poisson encoder, we try to describe each sample as a combination of topics. For example, given the two samples Police Officer and Senior Police Officer, we could describe the first as being one time a topic describing the fact of being a police officer, and the second as being one time the topic describing the fact of being a police officer, and one time a topic describing seniority. Now, in this example, the topics have pretty much the same names as the samples, which can be confusing, but try to focus on the idea of being a company senior, not on the word itself. This description gives us an encoding. In practice, of course, we don't want to do it by hand, we want to do it algorithmically. Mathematically, there is a nice way to model this with the formula f approximates x times lambda, which we want to optimize. F is a matrix of shape n times v, where n is the number of samples and v is the cardinality, the number of unique values, in the vocabulary. F is a count matrix of each unique value in the string decomposition. X is a matrix of shape n times t, where t is the number of topics, also called latent categories, we want to capture. The number of topics we choose is arbitrary, using more tends to capture more specific topics, while using less tends to capture more broad concepts. X is the encoding we handcrafted earlier, but in this context we don't know it, we want the computer to figure it out. Finally, lambda is a matrix of shape t times v. Each coefficient quantifies how much each vocabulary entry belongs to each topic. We know f, the count matrix, but we don't know the values of x and lambda. Therefore, we initialize both with random values, and we proceed to optimize the result using this algorithm, which I won't get into, but the takeaway is that by the end of this process, the gap encoder returns x. We can then use x to find the topics from the dataset. To convince us that these encoding methods help us achieve better results on real-world dirty data, let us perform a few benchmarks. We can compare the three methods we discussed earlier on the dataset about employee salaries. We will also add two more encoders for the sake of fairness. From this graph, we can see that the methods designed for dirty data outperform the classical ones, with the similarity encoder ahead of competition. And the best in all of that is that from a code perspective, these encoders are literally drop-in replacements, so they can be easily added to most code bases without major changes. Today, we saw that the similarity encoder is an improvement to the one-hot encoder, the gap encoder has a very interpretable output. As we saw, for dirty data, these encoders work better than traditional methods, and as mentioned, you can easily add them to your existing pipelines. On a final note, I'd like to mention that Dirty Cat also implements a few other methods that have their own advantages. You can review their principles and code on the official Dirty Cat website. Thank you.